came back to the island about 2 years ago. For the last 3 years, I would hear and other young professionals like myself, some of us in here call us millennials. I would always hear that, are you millennials so idealistic? You always believe you could change things. And this was a common theme amongst a lot of my friends also. And I believe that within government, over the last few years, we don't have enough of that. We don't have enough idealism. We don't have enough people taking the risk to make certain changes happen. I had a friend that wanted to open a business, and they went to the business license department with all the documents. And after all the documents were handed in, they went to pay. And as they went to pay, they were told that they have to go over to the receiver's office. I don't know if any of us see the traffic lately. They had to leave the business license department to go in traffic, to go to the receiver's office, to stand in line over there, pay there, to go back in traffic, to come back to the business license department, to stand in line again, to then hand in their document. And within, this is the idealistic part of the millennials, within 10 to 15 minutes, we thought, let's see if we can find a solution. So we asked, why can't we pay here? And they said the receiver's office and the finance ministry, they didn't want to accept any cash. So the next solution we thought was, can't we have a Maestro credit card machine at the department? For the last 2 weeks in the budget debate, we've been talking a lot about taxes, small businesses, and businesses in general. We're not talking about making things easier for these organizations. I think it's very, I believe in practicality also. I believe that we could come up with very simple solutions to make it easier for businesses to pay their fees and also pay their taxes. So one of my questions is to the finance minister is, what is the possibility of having a Maestro or debit or credit card system at all our points within government where we have to make payments? Is there any room in the budget to make this happen? If not, can we have a kiosk from someone from the receiver's office we represent at these payment areas? Again, I believe in practicality. I don't believe in someone leaving a location, it could be the Vrummy building either, leaving the Vrummy building to go over to the receiver's office to come back again and stand in line to make a payment. Another thing I believe in is benchmarking. So my next question is to the Minister of TIAT is, what is the process, what is the length of time it takes for the process of a business license? And what are the bottlenecks in that process? That question also goes to the Minister of Rumi. What is the length of time for the processing of a business, of a building permit? And what are the bottlenecks in that process? And the reason why I'm asking that question is not for information for myself. That question again will be asked next year budget debate, because I've been on the other side of this budget debate in the past as a financial controller, and during long, according to the president of parliament, long ungodly hours at times. And during the year, we don't hear anything again. We have 1-2 weeks of hundreds of questions, and during the year of parliament, nobody comes back to discuss these questions or topics. It becomes less important. But next year, I would like to see how much we have improved from 2016 in the processing of our business licenses and our permits. So the question again is, what is the processing time of a business license, building permit, and where are the bottlenecks? minister or to the Minister of Finance, to you, Madam Chair, had asked about our shares in UTS, and from what I understood, it was at 8%, and you mentioned that we do not collect any dividends from the shares. My question is why, even no matter how minuscule it might be, 8% of a billion is still a lot. Exactly. If it's that amount, 13%. To the Minister of TIAT, I would like to know how exactly is the budgeted amount derived for the different markets and tourism budget? How do we decide on the amounts to spend in each market? Is it decided by the amount of visitors that come from the market, the amount the visitors spend, and do we have data to back us up? And what do we, or what does the ministry consider a return on investment in those markets? So if we budget 500,000 guilders in a market, what do we consider a return on investment for our in those markets?
In all her glory? What excites you and fills your heart with joy? Is it his smile that brightens a room like the colors of the rainbow?
Make your Christmas colorific with Berger. Shop to win fantastic instant prizes and enter for a chance at a shopping trip for two to Miami with $1,000 spending money. See the rest for details.
Berger paints all the colors of you.
Life is a journey full of connections. You're in safe hands even when life starts too soon. You don't have to miss a single beat. When a bad hair day makes you sad, just sharing can bring you joy and more to come. They take the plunge, turn fear into faith, while you capture those beautiful moments. In the game of life, it's family that counts. They'll be there even when you lose. We all have our moments of reflection and hope. And when you feel you're losing everything in life, we're there because there's more to come. When life starts too soon, you don't have to miss a single beat. We're here to connect you and share life. Delta, when you want more.
GEBE has been faithfully serving the communities of St. Martin, powering your home and our economy. Come rain or shine, our qualified team of professionals are working hard 24 hours a day to provide you and your family with safe, reliable electricity and water. We use the latest technologies and test our products daily to maintain the highest international standards. Our friendly staff is always there to assist you, whether in person, over the phone, or online. We are committed to constantly improving our products and services, making them more efficient, effective, and environmentally friendly to serve you better today and our next generation of clients tomorrow. GEBE, powering a brighter future.
Our friend Megawati is here with tips to save you energy. 1. Turn your airco temperature up. 2. Use a ceiling fan instead. 3. Buy energy saving products. Save some green with NVGEBE.
Do you think that you've got what it takes to decorate? If yes, then sign up. Sign up for the Christmas Tree by Defense competition, which will be held from the 1st to the 31st of December 2016. The best decorated Christmas tree by Defense wins the grand prize of $3,000. There's a lot more prizes to be won. The early birds who submit their entry before the 18th of December 2016 will be displayed in the Daily Herald. For more information, email us at sxmchristmastree@gmail.com, or you can find us on Facebook, Christmas Tree by Defense. Don't forget, sign up and win. Win big.
Madam Chair, I'm going to piggyback a bit off of my colleague Silvio Matzel, what he said yesterday with a young lady. We all was in shock and awe. Nobody had anything to say when she stood in the House of Parliament and said, you know, where am I to go and what am I to do? I went to school with that young lady, Madam Chair. And I said it in the Central Committee. And it's not to attack the government. I said, I am going to vote for this budget. This budget has my approval. But it doesn't mean I can't be critical about certain things. Now, I understand how that young lady feels. And that is the same angle I was going when I addressed the Minister of Labor in the Central Committee, because government have done it to 9 individuals, and in a bad way, without compensation. I'm not going to linger on that, but I will reiterate my question and my stance, and I know the answer is going to be, Madam Chair, we are still waiting on the advice from the lawyers. So I'm asking again for the advice from the dismissal committee. Even though I know what the answer is going to be, but I wanted to be on record that I asked for this document. In addition to that, I never said that we should import a tax on car rentals. I never said that. But I approached the Minister of Justice and I asked him if he had looked into the proposal that the former Minister Duncan was coming with concerning the driver's license. So again, I'm asking the same question, Minister. Did you follow up on the information? Do you have any details on it? Can you please explain what that is all about? I want to ask each and every minister who is sitting here, do you know what is an Uber? I know you would know. Good. Because if we are looking at ways to bring entrepreneurship back in St. Martin, gypsies is illegal in this country. But buses and taxis don't go up in the Keys. They don't go into 911. And there's a lot of people living in those areas that walk into those areas. And only the gypsies go into those areas. Minister of TIAC, Minister of Justice, this is a new opportunity. A new opportunity to give Uber licenses to local Samaritans who don't have a job. A new opportunity to create a new revenue of taxing and investment to the country. What that is going to do, Minister of Justice, is going to weed out. It's going to weed out the gypsy drivers, set the rules, set the policies. Because today we have two ships in. And if you go up by the 4 or 5, and if you go up by the port terminal, there's a rift and a fight and a tug of war. Gypsies outside by the barriers, illegal taxis on the other side because of no regulation. We set the rules and the policies. You are not allowed to go there as an Uber driver. My sister finished work 2 o'clock every night in Oyster Bay. 2 o'clock. And it's $11 she pays every night from Oyster Bay to South Reward. $11. I told her, I said, but you're crazy. She said, I have no choice. A gypsy, $11. $11. Minister of Finance, why must I walk into a casino or a bank to change 50 euros? Let us create some change point. Create opportunities for entrepreneurs, for young people, for business people. Why? Why can't I walk into a change point on the debt side and change a 50 euro? Why must I go into a casino to change it? Why must I go into a bank to change it? Again, new business, new streams of revenue, new streams of taxation, new ways to bring money into this country. But like my colleague said, it's a ring around the rosy. We are doing the same thing over and over and over. We are not creating new business opportunities in this country.
Oh my, oh my, what an inventory list, and so unnecessary. But wait, your home contents are all insured by BeSure. That means that you determine the amount you want to insure. No inventory list, no hassle.
Are you BeSure? BeSure.
Bob, I can understand why you're parking so carefully. Of course, when you can get 80% discount on your B-Sure car insurance. But that's overdoing it, Bob.
Are you B-Sure? B-Sure.
Yeah.
What inspires you? Is it nature in all her glory? What excites you and fills your heart with joy? Is it his smile that brightens a room like the colors of the rainbow?
Make your Christmas colorific with Berger. Shop to win fantastic instant prizes and enter for a chance at a shopping trip for two to Miami with $1,000 spending money. See the rest for details.
Berger paints all the colors of you.
It's been said that behind every door, possibility awaits. How much possibility depends on which door you open first. Every day, we help our customers discover the possibilities in their lives. It all starts with a conversation. Scotiabank. Discover what's possible.
Madam Chair, how do we intend to stimulate the economy of St. Martin? The Minister has a presentation that he made, the Minister of Finance, in which, yes, he's on the right track. He may like it or he may not like it. In order for us to know where we are going, we must have a tax structure policy for this country. And why I say that? What are those we want to achieve by attracting investors to this country? If we don't present a competitive tax structure for investors who wants to invest in this country. Madam Chair, investors is not going to come from one day to the other because the beaches are beautiful, the scenery is nice, and then what with their investment? Also, we must make it attractive for local entrepreneurs in this country. Madam Chair, you know, those who know me over the last couple of days, there is something has been brewing in my mind. And I've seen it becoming a phenomenon in this country. For years, we see it, we feel it. Madam Chair, our people are having a hard time to keep up with taxes on this country called St. Martin. Especially people who owns a home. And I believe, Madam Chair, that this Parliament has a duty to the people of this country to protect their first home. Madam Chair, while I could have come with a motion, it was planning to come with a motion for the Minister to start the process that you cannot auction one's first main home in this country. We should have some sort of protection for our people. Because the easiest thing one can lose by taxes is your home. And it should not be the case. Madam Chair, the reason why I'm saying this, our people, there's no longer the ones who are in the forefront of this country like before. We're the ones who are losing out. We're the ones who are being the ones being targeted most as the tax department because we have nowhere to run. So, Madam Chair, that is the reason why
I talked about the issue of finding a solution to work with the tax department that your primary home should not be auctioned off. Should not be. Something we should leave in the hands of our people. Madam Chair, it is very important for our people. Madam Chair, during the campaigns, all of us promise tax relief, tax change. Many campaign promises was made during regarding this topic, Madam Chair. But Madam Chair, this is the time for us to put our money where our mouths are. Madam Chair, if I'm not mistaken, we are the highest profit tax rate in the region, and experts tell me that companies that have branches throughout the region, including St. Martin, file their profit taxes elsewhere, not on St. Martin. And in fact, I'm told that large companies, among others, file their profit tax on Curaçao. Curaçao has gradually reduced the profit tax rate from 34.5% since 2010 annually to 22.5%, with the objective to decrease it even further to 20%. Madam Chair, next door, the best islands is at zero. Meanwhile, we are still at 34.5%. All indications are that lowering the profit tax rate has resulted in increased revenues for the government of Curaçao. Madam Chair, I know the minister is busy with his plan, but I hope we don't remain stubborn and maintain the 34.5%. At the same time, complain about lowering the rate of compliance.